was just going on last time, so I hope he can hear me. I don't know. I should have checked beforehand. But I didn't. Okay. So I can't go there. Now I get it. Now I can get it. Whatever's in there. Fashal pack. Ooh, lovely. Ooh. Climb up, Ben.
The way up. All it takes is a few good handholds.
Hmm.
All right. Made it. Wonder what we'll find.
From this device. Do you wish to deploy item privileges to recover purge data?
Oh yes, I believe I do.
The file has been recovered.
Elizabeth, good to, it's been years.
Where's your legal team, Ted?
No need. I dropped all 18 lawsuits the moment you landed. I assume your data confirms this.
All right, this promises to be interesting.
Perhaps we could have lunch brought in. You know, get reacquainted.
I know you, Ted. You've screwed something up, something big, or you wouldn't have eaten the crow necessary to get me here. So spit it out.
There's a glitch in the chariot line.
Your killer robots?
Peacekeepers, yes. Those.
So shut them down.
Obviously, Liz, we would, if we could. They're not responding.
Are you telling me a swarm has gone rogue, Ted?
It's worse than that.
Show me the data, then. And I'll take that lunch. Alone.
Hmm. Ted
Farrow brought Elizabeth Sobek here, but they hated each other.
Another didn't really hate. Has been
this isn't a glitch. It's a catastrophe.
Fully aware. It's bad.
Bad?
Jesus, Liz.
It's not bad, Ted. It's apocalyptic. You built a line of killer robots.
Peacekeepers.
That consume biomass as fuel.
In emergencies.
And you made them capable of self-replication.
Limited self-manufacture controlled.
Not anymore. The glitch severed chain of command. The only nation this swarm answers to now is itself.
You think I'd...
Everything else is just food. And at the rate it's replicating, Ted, it will strip the Earth bare in 15 months. We're not talking fall of civilization, we're talking extinction.
I get it, Liz. So how do I stop it while it's contained?
It's not contained, it can't be!
You know what I mean?
Right. Before the truth gets out, you mean.
Liz, I will do anything you say. Keep working it, and whatever you recommend, I'll do.
I'm gonna hold you to that, Ted.
Hmm. Ted fucked up badly.
The Faro robots threatened all life on Earth, but somehow she defeated them. The world of the old ones fell, but life went on, or we wouldn't be here.
Yeah.
A final cell has been recovered.
Crouching at zero dawn.
Hmm.
Jesus, Liz. There has to be another way.
If there were a nicer way to fix your mess, I would have proposed it.
But this? This? When I asked you to find a cure, I didn't expect it to be worse than the disease.
It's not, Ted. It may be grim, but it's our only chance. Now sign the proposal.
Sign it? I can't sign that.
Yes, you can.
That? Liz, I cannot in good conscience sign that.
You've got a choice, Ted.
I know.
I am speaking to you from a VTOL en route to U.S. Robot Command. In 15 minutes, I meet with General Harris and the rest of the Joint Chiefs.
What? Are you crazy?
Now your choice is what I tell them. Sign, and I'll tell them the wealthiest corporation on Earth has guaranteed the funds necessary to build Zero Dawn. Exactly as I've designed it. Or don't sign, and I will make sure they and everyone else on this planet knows the real cause of the glitch.
Jesus, Liz. You don't have to threaten me. I'll sign.
Look on the bright side, Ted. From here on out, you get to do what you've always been good at. Footing the bill while others get their hands dirty.
God forgive me.
What made her solution so terrible? What did she do to stop the robots?
Yeah.
Executive access detected. Express lift opened.
This doesn't add up. Sobek couldn't have been my mother. She lived ages ago. All this searching, and I'm still no closer.
That's your reaction to everything you've just learned? To whine like a spoiled child?
You should really try talking that way to me face to face.
As you wish. Do you really have no idea how monumental are the discoveries you just made, Aloy? I expected more of you.
So, you have a face. Got a name to go with it?
Of all the questions you could ask right now, that's the one you choose. I've spent decades searching the ruins of the old ones, trying to solve the mystery of what happened to them. For years, I've suspected that feral robots destroyed their civilization, but I could never confirm it. And in minutes, you uncover more ancient knowledge than I have in a lifetime, and what you want to know is my name. Silence, that's my name. Now, why don't you try asking another question? Something less trivial.
You have no idea what I've been through, how hard it's been. My whole life, I grew up not knowing who I am or where I came from, and then come the Eclipse trying to kill me just because I look like this Elizabeth Sobek woman.
And they killed the man who raised you and you found the mountain as a baby. I already know this through your focus.
The point is, every time I take a step forward, the answers slip farther from my grasp. You just don't understand.
It's not that I don't understand, Aloy. It's that I don't care. If the answers keep slipping away every step you take, then you best start running to catch up. Maybe then you'll realize just how big your problems really are.
What exactly are you talking about?
You've chased a personal riddle into a crowd of larger mysteries. The common thread is your connection to Elizabeth Sobek.
But what is that connection? She couldn't have been my mother if she lived centuries ago.
We don't know the connection yet. The only way to find out is to keep going, to keep making discoveries. Thanks to you, we've only just now learned that feral robots once threatened to end life on Earth.
But it didn't happen. The old one's civilization was destroyed, but life was saved.
Obviously. So, what did Elizabeth do? How did she stop the robots before all was lost?
What was Project Zero Dawn?
Exactly the question. Now, are you ready to go get the answer?
Of course I am.
Then why are you still standing here?
Not so fast, Silence. You've got some explaining to do.
I've told you quite enough. If you still got questions, be quick about it and stop wasting my time.
You said you've known for some time that Faro war machines destroyed the civilization of the Old Ones.
The evidence pointed that way. But until now, I never knew the full scope of their danger. That they could process organic matter into fuel, or that the Horus class could manufacture more robots. Like a cauldron on legs.
But the robots we've seen so far, the Corruptors and Deathbringers, they don't do those things.
Not yet, anyway. So far, we haven't encountered any that are undamaged. At full power, who knows what they're capable of. Now, if that's enough talking, be on your way.
Oh, no. I'm just getting started. You've been getting a free ride on my focus, risking nothing while I risk everything. All I have to do is take this thing off my head, and you'll be blind, deaf, and dumb. So quit complaining and answer my questions.
Very well. Proceed.
Who are you, Silence? And what are your intentions?
You really need to make this personal? I'm a lone wanderer who left his tribe behind a long time ago. An explorer of forbidden places, a searcher of lost knowledge. Exactly as I said.
Why do you know so much about the Eclipse?
I happen to know a lot about a lot of things. If what you're really asking is whether I work for the Eclipse or anyone else, I don't. I am nothing if not independent.
So far as I can tell, the Eclipse are just following orders. It's Hades who wants me dead. Who is he?
I don't know. The Eclipse describe him as a buried shadow, some kind of devil.
That thing that spoke to me outside, that made that focus explode. That was Hades. It didn't seem like a person or a machine. More like a phantom. A terrible voice.
All that's certain is that he wants you dead.
Because of my connection to Elizabeth. Has to be.
Hades is using the Eclipse to resurrect Pharaoh robots.
But if Elizabeth found a way to stop them centuries ago, if she made special weapons, maybe Hades is worried I'll do the same thing.
In some of the ancient data I've recovered, there are hints of so-called super weapons being developed. Maybe to stop the robots, the civilization of the Old Ones had to destroy itself.
Maybe Hades was the reason why, like, the glitch was actually Hades developing. Maybe the AI took over the robots and they had to.
You've been using my focus to spy on me. How is that possible?
Every focus emits a signal, a voice that only other focuses can hear. I know how to string those voices together, how to make them talk to each other, to communicate, even over vast distances.
How do you learn to do that?
Years of study and experimentation. In principle, it's not so different from how you override machines. I override focuses.
And you can spy through other Eclipses' focuses, too.
Usually. All I'll say is that overriding the connections is complicated.
Is there any chance that Elizabeth Sobeck could still be alive somehow?
It's highly unlikely, but not impossible. Some of the ancient data I've recovered includes mentions of life extension techniques. Pharmaceuticals, mostly, an ancient word for medicine. But some were still trying to perfect ways of freezing and unfreezing people.
Freezing and unfreezing people?
Cryogenics, they called it. But there were problems with it. Given Elizabeth's technological acumen, I can't definitively rule out that she found a way to make herself immortal. But this is speculation. Wasting time.
Elizabeth told Ted Faro she was headed for a place called U.S. Robot Command to tell people about Zero Dawn.
The place still exists as a ruin. The Asuram call it the Grave Horde.
Grave Horde. Cheery name.
Hmm. You'll find it in the Eastern Mountains, buried under the tangled coils of a metal devil, or a BOR-7 Horus, rather, as we're learning to call them. I'll contact you when you get there.
I can't wait. Someday we'll meet him. Person, and your manners had better be improved. Well, getting down will be a lot faster than getting up here, at least. U.S. Robot Command next, to learn the secrets of Zero Dawn.
Finally, okay. I was just gonna look for the closest campfire dude. Yeah, flash over the over by the dude. Carry on. Campfire.
Good for an old remedy.
You there! I hope you've come to help, because we're getting slaughtered out here.
Uh-huh. Interesting. Yeah, so it's only straight there. Okay. Well, site's got cauldrons. Things, I think it.
Could you come here for a moment? You look like a brave. Can we talk? You're a gift from All Mother. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Well, it looks like we have to walk the rest of the way, God dang it. Thanks to the fact that I suck at what do you call it?
I hope you've come to help because we're getting slaughtered out here.
Just stay out of their way.
Nice. Okay, well. Run, bitch, run. Okay. We end this episode soon.
Fascinating.
Get over here! She's coming!
Around the room.
Same play as Akron. Base defense locks it down. We engage, sever the limb, blast out the phantoms.
Are you getting this, Silence? Silence? Enduring victory. What did that mean? Whatever it was, it doesn't seem to have turned out very well. Must have been where the soldiers slept. Like the lodge in Mother's Heart, I guess. What was this place? Furnishings were metal. How'd they ever get comfortable? It was the metal world. Guess they were used to it. Just one bed. Maybe their war chief's room. These wires must run to the power source. Red light. Guess that means more power.
That's lovely. Fall to my death. Oh my god, wow, I've been recording for a long time in this episode. Okay, so now I'm going to leave that episode. So don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe, join me today. I'll see you guys next episode. Peace.